am officially going to start making training videos again. I know I've been slacking the last couple of, year and a half, 2 years. I've kind of had to rethink everything last night. I was going through kind of a really bad phase where I was fully addicted to not doing anything, really. Facebook and all that lovely stuff. So, I have made it up a decision last night while I was thinking, laying in bed, kind of playing the pros and cons. When I originally started the YouTube account, it was basically for me to keep track of how Sassy was progressing, because I didn't have any videos of my earlier years with her. When I first got her, she was 2 years old, and I didn't catch any of the training that I did on her. She was kind of crazy, she was dangerous, and it saddens me because I really wanted to make sure that I could reflect back on those times and see how far we progressed, but I didn't have any of that, so I was kind of upset. Then when I got Percy in for training, I got him, you know, from start to finish, from riding to lunging to everything in between. And then I ended up buying him, and I kept him from, you know, our first ground pulls to, you know, shows and paces and stuff like that until I sold him a little bit over a year ago. He was sold not because he was a bad horse. I kept him for about 4 years. He was basically a horse I was going to sell, retrain and sell anyways. I did fall in love with him. That's why I kept him for so long. In the end, he didn't want to jump anymore. And I'm a big time eventer. I like doing my paces, and the pacing do have jumps. Granted, I could have gone around the jumps, but most of the paces that I go to don't have a work around the jumps. You would have to go at least, you know, 20 minutes out of your way to get around that particular jump. So, and he was becoming really dangerous when it came to jumping fences. He would do a dirty ditch, or he just, it got to the point where the last couple of times I took him to a pace, he wouldn't lift his legs up, and we almost had two rotational falls within, you know, a 20-minute time frame. So at that point, he was telling me he was done jumping. We had a chiropractor come out. We had a vet come out. We had his teeth checked. We had his feet checked. We had everything done to ensure that he was not in pain, and he wasn't. He was 100% sound. He just didn't like his job. So I did sell him. I sold him to a lovely young lady who is keeping him as a trail horse. All she does is trail ride him in a Western saddle. He doesn't have to look at a cavaletti. He doesn't have to look at a ground pole. All he does is trail riding, and she loves him to death. And I still get updates from him, you know, at least once or twice every other month. So I know he's doing good. He's in a good home. I don't have to worry about him. I'm still in contact with this young lady. So if she ever does decide to have to rehome him, I will try my darnest to buy him back if I have the money at the time. So with that being said, you know, I got Fancy. Fancy is going to be 3 this year. I got her as a year and a halfling. I have all my groundwork recorded from her from start to finish. I have our first rides recorded. You know, we're going to have everything recorded as far as our first jumping next year, our first POV cameras this year out on trail, our first trail rides, all of that. And I found that really important. And that's basically what my YouTube account was basically supposed to be, is my documentation of the horses that I've worked over the years. Granted, there are horses that I've worked with that I did not record just because I didn't have permission from the owners. Who's it, what's it? You know, I give riding lessons. I don't record most of those because most of the people, they'd rather not be on film. Because, you know, the YouTube society, they're mean. You know, they criticize everything. And for a new rider, they don't want to have someone say, oh, you know, their heels should be down. They should be carrying their hands like so. And I won't do that to my students. That's why I won't record most of their videos. There are a couple of them that I did record just to play back for them. And, you know, they've gone to bigger, better things, and I will only train to so far. Granted, I do have a British Horse Society certificate to train up to, you know, 2-star eventing and stuff like that, but I don't feel confident in myself teaching a person to jump over a 2-star cross-country fence. I myself believe that if I'm not jumping at that level, I should not be teaching at that level. The highest I will jump anymore is about 3 foot. And that, you know, comes with its own risks. I mean, 3 foot is not that high, but, you know, I'm older, I'm wiser, I have a child, I have a husband, I can't get hurt. You know, I had my own rotational fall when I was younger. You know, it did do some damage back in the day. I think I'm coming down with the older pain now, with me having back pain for the last month. It's been really severe. It's been really hard to move. And those are all past injuries that I'm trying to work through, and it does hurt a lot. I mean, I've been trying to pop it. I've been massaging it. It just hurts so bad. But, you know, I'm working through it. So the main point of this video is to let you guys know that I will be doing training videos again, Q&A answers and stuff like that. I just want to inform you guys. I did have one Q&A question sent to me via email, and it is from Annalise, and she said she was wondering why people only get on horses from one side, and if it was possible to get on horses on both sides, if it was allowed. Well, Annalise, the question is, back in the day, okay, now you have to think colonial time, when the Native Americans still owned everything and the English invaded the U.S. before it was the U.S., the modern world, the new world. The Indians got on the horses from the Indian side. Once the Spaniards lost horses and the Indians were able to take the horse, Native Americans were able to break in the horses their natural way, which was the best natural horsemanship you can ever learn, is go to a Native American and have them teach you. They would get on the horse on the offside. It's what we call the offside, or not the good side, okay? The offside is on the left side. Or, let me think, let me rephrase that. I get on my horses from both sides, so I don't really remember anymore. Yeah, so you're going to get on your horse normally on the left side, okay? So the Native Americans used to get on the horses on the right side because they didn't have anything on their person except for their bow and arrow. Now, when the cavalry started doing the military horses, the war horses, they would get on from the left side. And the basic concept because of that is because most cavalry men had swords, okay? They had the swords on their left hip. So if they got on the horses on the Native American side, they would potentially harm the horse. They would potentially stab the horse. Now, because most people are right-handed, most of them carry their swords on the left side. So this is how people started getting on the right side of the horse, okay? So they would get on the left side because when they were getting on the horse, they didn't risk in injuring the animal. And because they're all, most of them were right-handed, they could grab their sword at the same time and ride. So that's why there's a discrepancy between the left and the right side of the horse. Now, which side you get on your horse is totally up to you. I mean, I get on my horses from both sides. If I can't get on from the right side, I'll get on from the left side. If I can't get on from the left side, I'll get on the right side. It all depends on where I'm at. If I'm on a trail and the trail's really narrow and there's, let's say, a ditch on the common side to get on the horse, then I'll get on the other side. I mean, it's, your horse should be vice versa. You should be able to get on your horse from either side. You should be able to get off your horse from either side without them acting up. If you notice on my first riding video with Fancy, I get on from both sides and I get off from both sides. I train my horses to get used to it all. Now, eventually, I will start sliding off her butt. That will be down the line when she starts getting used to things. She's still a little iffy with me touching around her tail base. So she is prone to kicking, which is bad because I got kicked by her once and it really did hurt, so I'm not going to have her do that to me again until I'm really used to her not kicking. So to answer the question is, if you want to get on your horse from the left or right side, just do it. Your horse is going to be better off that way. He ain't going to be spooky. He's going to be more desensitized from what you're doing on either side. It's also good practice for the horse to have both sides of their brain balanced out. Left and right side should always be balanced out depending on what you're doing. It's the same goes to if you're despooking. If you're despooking on the left side only, the right side's going to be a little bit more aware and not as desensitized. So if you're working, make sure you balance off both sides so that you have an even horse. Now remember, when you despook a horse, you're going to keep doing it until the horse stops reacting. Once they stop reacting, you're going to give that release. You know, you can pet them and stuff. A lot of people say the release is praise enough. Not every horse works the same way, okay? Some horses, the release, yes, is the praise, but some horses like to be pet. So if you're going to get the release and your horse is one that is affectionate and wants to praise and stuff, go ahead and rub them down on their neck. Don't smack them. Okay, horses don't like to be smacked. Rub them nicely in a circle, you know, around the face and the ears and stuff like that, just as a praise. You know, that's basically what you're going to do, you know, even out both sides. So that's my first video in a very long time. If you guys have any other questions you need answered, go ahead and leave it down below in the comment section. I also do want to apologize that when YouTube renewed itself or upgraded its system, I did notice last night when I was clicking through all my videos that I had so many comments that were not pinged through to me to let me know that I had comments on the videos. So if you commented, let's say, 6 years ago and you never got a response, I am so sorry. I never saw it until last night. I don't think I should respond to them because they're so old. I'm not sure if those questions were ever answered between the 6 year time frame, but I will try my hardest. I promise to answer all the questions that I get on every single video if I see them. Again, any video that is over, I think it's over 3 years or 2 years old, I didn't receive any of those comment notifications. And as you guys know, I do put approval comments only because I don't like haters. You know, if you're gonna comment on a video saying, oh, you shouldn't do that to that poor horse because he's gonna be, it's gonna be detrimental to its brain. Sorry, honey, it's not gonna be approved. I have a lot of younger viewers on my channel and I don't want them to be subject to negativity. I'm in a firm belief not to cuss on my videos. I don't cuss on my videos, at least not that I remember. I try to give correct information to ensure that all my younger viewers know what they're supposed to be doing and what they're not supposed to be doing. I'm a big, you know, I'm a big believer in wearing helmets. My helmet has saved my life countless numbers of times. Actually, I'm probably on my fifth helmet. You know, if you're breaking in young babies or riding horses, you don't know, you fall off, a horse can step on your head, and if you got a helmet, yeah, your brain's saved. So I'm in a firm belief in preaching wearing a helmet. I'm in a firm belief in preaching and wearing long pants and long sleeves, or at least, you know, cut off sleeves, no spaghetti straps while you're riding. Proper footwear, you know, I'm a firm believer in that. And I feel like as a professional, I need to make sure that my younger viewers understand that. I don't want people commenting on my videos saying, oh, you know, you don't have to wear a helmet because it's all just for looks. No, it's not. Helmets are for safety. Okay, so there you go. I don't need people saying, you know, you don't need to do a one rein stop because if you pull on both reins, the horse should automatically stop if it's well trained. No, not true. If the horse bolts, two reins isn't going to help you, honey. Okay. Two reins is going to make the horse fight harder. It's going to run faster and you're SOL, really. So I'm a firm believer in giving people the proper information. If I don't know the information, I look it up. I do research. I'm always learning. You know, I'm in my 30s. I've been doing this for a very long time. I believe that, you know, if I don't know something, I'm not going to say something wrong. I'm going to look for the answer, make sure it's properly the right answer and the safest answer to give a young rider. You know, I always preach, don't do anything alone. If you're new to doing, let's say, a trick, doing tricks with your horse, or going on trail for your first time, or taking a new horse, you know, to a show, don't go by yourself, go with a partner. Make sure someone always know where you're going. You know, let them know when you expect to return. Just in case something happens. You know, things still happen to me. I still get bucked off. My horse comes running home. I go the same route every single day, so my horses know which way to come home versus coming down on the road. They go around the field like they've been taught. It's, you know, habit forming. Their habit is to follow the same path. And my husband knows where I'm going. He knows exactly how long I'm going to be out, and I have my phone on me all the time. The trick is if you don't have a case, okay, for your phone, and this is a big phone. This is my new 6S Plus. Normally, I had a 5S, which was a lot smaller. I got this new phone a couple of months ago just because I needed the video capability. So I bought myself a new pack that is kind of like a fanny pack that goes across your chest. And this is where this phone sits when I ride. It's always on me, okay? If you have a smaller phone and you wear a sports bra, you can shove it up into your sports bra, make sure it sits there. I used to do that. It's nasty because it gets sweaty and ugh. But if it's in the case, you're good, okay? Stick it down your boot. Stick it somewhere where the phone is always on you. That way, if you do fall off, you can you can reach for it and you can call. I've had, you know, Percy bucked me off a couple of years ago where I got stranded in a field. I thought I broke my hip. That's probably another past injury that's coming back to bite me in the butt. And my phone was in my bra. I whipped it out. You know, I wiped the sweat off of it and I called the barn and let them know, look, I'm in the back field. My horse is still with me, but I think I broke something. Can you come pick me up? You need to make sure that you are able to communicate with people regardless. You know, never just take your horse and go somewhere. Let someone know that you're going somewhere, especially if you're a younger rider, okay? I understand that you young guys are, you know, full of life and bounce really good, and us older people, we hit the dirt and we just kind of implant into the dirt and we have to kind of roll out, but you young people bounce. Regardless, you know, go with a friend, let someone know that you're going, especially your parents. You know, if you're going to go on a trail ride with, let's say, your horse named Dakota, and you get stuck somewhere and no one knows where you're at, that's a dangerous situation. So make sure you tell your mom and your dad when you're going, how long you're going, you know, when you're leaving the barn. So let's say you finish tacking up and you're done and you're just now getting ready to leave and you've been at the barn for 20 minutes, call your parents or send them a text being like, it's 3:30 now, I'm just now tacking up, I'm gonna go on trail now, I should be back in 30 minutes to an hour. Let them know where you're going. And most barns have routes. They have like left pasture trail and the right pasture trail, the apple orchard, the lake trail, the deer run, the pipeline. You know, they all come with their wonky names. So make sure you let them know exactly where you're going so that they know if something happens and let's say your horse runs back by itself, they know how to find you. So I've rambled on long enough. We're almost at we are at 17 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and let this go here. I will try to make more videos this week. I've actually, I'm taking a hiatus from Facebook because I think that's been taking a lot of my time. So I'm going to try to wean myself off of Facebook. So there you go. I'm going to try to make more videos versus be on Facebook. It is snowing again out here. I will take the camera so you guys can see that. Even though I do want to ride, oh, my back hurts so bad. We are getting snow again. And I don't know if you guys can pick it up on camera. Sassy is not too thrilled. Hi, Sass! She's in the mud. She hates it. She wants to come inside. So I will let you guys go, and again, like I always preach, stay safe out there, make sure you're wearing your helmet, heels down, and have a fun ride, guys. I will talk to you guys later, and I promise I will try to make more videos, at least 2 a week, if at all possible, or maybe 3. Let's try 2, and I will try to do 3. If I do 3, that's the bonus thing. If not, well, can't hold it against me. I will definitely try to make videos at least every Monday and Friday. If I do ride, there, of course, will be more video. Right now, I'm not riding because, obviously, it's snowing again. My footing's crap. I'm so enthused about that. I'm going to clean my stalls, and I'm going to get my horse ready for dinner. I will talk to you guys later. Bye.